What's going on, paisanos? Is the car not working? You good? Okay. What's going on, paisanos? V here, and hopefully you guys can hear me a lot better. I recorded my other video, and it's not bad, but it was sounding muffled. So it's about 60 degrees out today, so that's motorcycle riding weather to me. We're gonna be going to locals. Today's a special event. It's for a playmat of the Live Twins, and kind of want to win it. I'm also running late for locals. There's nothing else I can say other than the fact that I'm trying to get there on time. They're really good though about holding everything up. They're like, hey, we'll give an extra couple minutes for the guys running a little bit late, which is kind of cool. Being a buddy of mine's, he drove pretty far to get to locals today, so it's a pretty fun event that's gonna be happening today. I'm actually really excited about it. Look at that. How gorgeous is that? Today I'm playing Bray PK. I also might list probably after this video. I think it's the best deck in the meta, unfortunately. And I mean unfortunately, because it's the best deck to go Artifact Psylocke. That's why. I feel like if there's other decks out in this game that can go Artifact Psylocke better, they would be better. They would be the best deck in the meta, but unfortunately we don't have it like that. The best deck in the game is the deck to make your opponent play the less amount of Yu-Gi-Oh! And that is the meta in a nutshell. I know a lot of players who want to play a lot of cool things. I mean, Eldritch sounds really good in theory until your Draco back, you know, your Draco back bounces back your skill drain, and then what are you going to do? I think Lancium might be easily the best hand trap in the game, just because so many decks have to make a crap board at best and get stomped out the following turn against other combo decks. I have a lot of decks I want to play and test for the meta, so I'm going to be putting them up on this channel. I play really competitive Yu-Gi-Oh, so I'm obviously, like, I put a lot of the thought into these decks, the main side extra. I find the side not being needed as much, especially for locals. So the way I see it is a lot of players build a side deck to play against the overall meta, and that's something I do too. And that's something that you should do if you're going to regionals or event you don't know what the players are playing, or any big event. You should build it that way. But my locals, there's certain cards that are just better than other cards. And it gets to the point where, do you want to side against the entire meta, or do you want to side against your locals so you don't get blown out by random cards? And everyone's basically doing that as locals. So I think it's smart to do that. So that's what I put in. I didn't do everything as much, but I have some stuff that I think will give me an advantage in this locals. Most players need to know that, like, you could drop it the scythe, which I think a lot of players don't know for some ungodly reason, but it's really important. Like, just know that your opponent does a Psylocke on you. Wait till the scythe hits board, and then you go dropless. I'm pretty sure you go dropless then. I looked online, and the internet never lies to me. The worst part about being late is being behind a slow car that's in the fast lane. No! We do the 45 minute Yu-Gi-Oh! Time rules. So, not the 55 like they do in, like, you know, remote duels. So, it gets kind of goofy, like, when you're trying to play and you're losing time. And like I said, there's going to be a Prinket play here. There's going to be a Sword Soul player here. And the last thing I want to do is losing time to these decks that somehow just magically play slower. If only there was a way to get these players to speed up in time. Ugh. If only we had that magical formula.
What's going on, everybody? Right now, one draw, one win. Yeah, the guy threw three hand traps. Three hand traps. So, draw and a win.
That's spicy.
16 players, four rounds. Yeah, we're doing pretty good.
A little bit, but hurts the opponent more, that's what matters.
Alright, so we're currently X three. We didn't lose. We had one tie and a bunch of wins. The deck is really, really good. I literally call this deck the waiting room. Despia waiting room is what PK is for some players. And for me, it's definitely that. Like, it's Despia waiting room. I have everything max ready for Despia that's in this deck. And everything else, I just don't. I have like common, whatever. Like, I don't care. Like, this deck's really good for now. It's misses right now. And deck definitely plays really consistent. People still playing? You can see over here. And this kid over here just.
They're playing as well, but it don't matter. They weren't ready for it.
X gonna give it to you.
So we're back home, and this is the deck I played. It's Phantom Knight, Adventurers. Nothing really exciting, but I did make some changes that is a little bit different from most builds you're gonna see. It's a 41 card deck, and I have the extra side deck over here. And I'll give the whole deck profile, and afterwards I'll also tell accessories, because the number one thing I get axed on these deck profiles is not necessarily the cards or my decisions of why I chose to play certain cards. It's mostly the accessories. So let's go to the deck once again. It's 41 cards. We're playing 3 Phantom Knight, Torrent Scales, 3 Silent Boots, 2 Itch and Cloak, 1 Stained Greed, and 1 Rag Gloves. I sorted everything by engine. We're running 2 Fog Blades, 1 Shade Brigadine, and 1 Knight's Wings. Both of these cards are really good, and you just really play 2 Fog Blade. The only time you really need a third one if you're playing a longer game state, and you got any PK player, none of them want to play a longer game state. They want the game over by turn 2 at most, so I think 2 Fog Blades more than enough. And once again, Shade Brigadine and Nightspring definitely have a place in this deck. You'll see a lot of profiles that play one or the other, but you can play both and it works perfectly. For the Phantom Knight core, it's the Aramazir. 1 Faithful Adventure, 1 Trickleback. Obviously, you still play the 3 Water Enchantress and 1 Griffin Rider. So that's the entire core for that deck. Then we have other cards like 3 E-Telly, 1 Psychic Wheeler, and 1 Psychic Tracker. Then we run, you know, obviously the Fusion Destiny. We have run 2 of them. 1 Dasher and 1 Celestial, so there's that engine. And then we're going to be running Forbidden Droplets. I think everyone's kind of running at this meta, especially this deck. So I'll put this aside. I'll talk about this in a second. I also play Artifact Psy, Rhoda, and Foilless Burial. So the 3 cards inside the run, some people are running like Ash Blossom and Joy Spring. But I feel like Artifact Glancia or Droll Locker were one of the 2 cards I wanted to put in the main deck. And the reason why is because you play against Mirror Match, you Lancia them, you just make a better board. You play against any kind of, even Sword Souls, this card's really good against. Eldritch, this card's really good against. So I felt like if I had to play against a Mirror Match, I would just go Lancia on them, and then next time I would just kill them. So that's my thought process behind this card. It's a really, really good card, and I really like it a lot. Up next, we're going to go over the side deck. Side decks really vary from local to locals. Gamma, I think, is pretty much staple at this point for this deck. I'll talk about that in a second. 1 Harpy's Felduster, 1 Red Reboot, triple Lightning Storm. People are running, like, evenly matched, but I feel Lightning Storm could be running any kind of deck that can kill your opponent that turn. Like, when I'm playing against a deck and he's playing a lot of back row, if I Lightning Storm that back row, we can kill them this turn. So, that's why I like Lightning Storm. With evenly matched, giving it about a face, does it's a little bit too much. And of course, you're still running 3 Nibiru. Not every deck is running the adventure package. And if they're not running the adventure package, this card is that much better of a card. So people kind of thought about this card, but I didn't. So at my locals, they play 45-minute time limits. So it's obviously a shorter time than remote duels. And they're playing Sanctioned Yu-Gi-Oh! So I decided to put in Ghost of Spooky Dogwood. I didn't play at all today, but any chance I was to go into time, I feel like this card would make the difference between winning and losing in time. And if it's 1 card to be time, we gotta put this in. It's because the time rules are scuffed, I'll be honest. Konami needs to fix them. They're never going to. Alright, so we have a bunch of tokens, a field center. I'll talk about all this in all my accessories in a second. 1 Cherubini, 1 Rusty Bardiche, 1 Dagda, nothing too intuitive here. 1 Anaconda, 1 Nightmare Phoenix, Nightmare Unicorn, Axis Cold Talker, Almirage, Link Spider, double Breaksword, Donna Magician, Zeus, Leviere, and Destiny Hero Phoenix and Force. So I feel like every single one of these cards are perfect. Like, there's not 1 card I want to add in or 1 card I want to take out.
Every single one of these cards make perfect sense to put in the deck. And if you have any questions about it, let me know in the comments down below. Alright, so let's talk about the accessories. Number one accessory, obviously, is going to be this amazing metal field center. There might be a couple still left. It's smarttcg.com. I'll have the link down below. Also, my promo code in case you guys want to buy it for yourself. It's a metal field center. It's really heavy. It's really thick. It doesn't even need a a sleeve on it, but I like to put a sleeve on it. It feels... I mean, look at that. It's just absolutely gorgeous. And it's, I mean, look, it's beautiful. And I used it, you know, I once again, I cut my phone, I popped it in there, and every game, it just made life easy. So I like this a lot. And everyone kept asking me, where did I get this? Up next, we're going to be the extra deck sleeves. The outer sleeves are obviously from Imperium Duelist. These are sold out, I believe. They should be hopefully be getting a second run, hopefully. Imperium Duelist definitely has the best extra deck sleeves, the outer sleeves in the game. I mean, if we're talking about, like, extra deck outer sleeves, there's, like, the base ones. Hold on. Actually, I'm over here. There's these, which aren't bad. I'm not saying these are terrible, but Imperium Duelist sleeves are just, I mean, it's night and day, let's be honest. Like, these are good, but these are better. This is McDonald's. You're not going to starve today. This is like Cheesecake Factory. You're going to eat good all day. No one brags about McDonald's. Okay. So, yeah, these, and they look absolutely beautiful and perfect, and I do like how the dragon, each one is eating the symbol. See right there. I just like that. The back of the sleeves, I actually had a choice of what I wanted to play, but the Ivy Masquerina Motorcycle one is amazing. One, I like motorcycles, obviously, but two, the artwork on this looks absolutely amazing. So you got the backwards clean artwork, and you got the front with this in your sleeves. So like I said, this is all, go in the description. I have Imperium Duelist website there. I have my promo code in case you do want to buy some extra sleeves. Try them out. I guarantee you buy one, you'll be not addicted for life. Like, these are absolutely stunning. Big shout out to Imperium Duelist and Smart TCG for hooking me up with this and giving me the opportunity to show this to everybody. Like, huge. For the sleeves, I didn't get a chance to play Imperium Duelist's new sleeves. I'm probably going to have that done once Despias come out. I'm thinking, I don't know, I might do it sooner. But right now, these are mint. These are by Dragon Shield. And yeah, I mean, they're not bad. Once again, Dragon Shield used to be, like, special. And now to me, and this is only to me, they're becoming bland. A couple of reasons. Number one, I think that Dragon Shield sleeves are, and comment down below if this happened to you. These are brand new sleeves, and you can, I'm not sure if you can see that. They're already getting, they have dirt on them. Mine is pretty much clipped. They're pretty much clipped. Like, what do you want me to do? Cut off the cuticles? What? What's a cuticle? And I think the biggest issue with these sleeves is they get dirty easily. I'm going to try Imperium Duelist sleeves out soon. I'll probably have a video coming out about that. But, yeah, I don't like these sleeves. They're only here for now. And like I said, these used to be things everybody used to, like, flex on. And now it's kind of, like, standard. And with standard, nobody cares about it. If it's something unique and special, everyone kind of wants it more. That's the way I feel about this. And then we just have tokens. Nothing too crazy. These are the old KCs. Obviously, you got that one. You can probably buy these on Amazon. They're kind of nice. Just Kyber Corp. Sometimes you can see them. Sometimes you can't. Unfortunately, like the OCG sleeves get bought up really fast. I mean, they're not bad, to be honest with you. I'm not too crazy about them. So, yeah, listen. The number one thing I got commented on today was not the deck or anything like that. Like, once again, it's very standard of a deck, but it is very efficient. And Artifact Lancia allows you to, like, just win games you're not really supposed to win. But the extra deck sleeves were just beautiful. Everyone kept looking at them and seeing how amazing they were. And, of course, the field center. Every time I would sit down, I would get my phone, I'll tap it right over to my field center, put it down, and people would see that, and they like that a lot. Once again, this is something that I really do like a lot. I like to have the accessories down packed. I also use the Yu-Gi-Oh! World Championship deck box. This thing is garbage. It's already starting to fade in the corner. Anyone has one of these, the regional deck boxes? You can see they're fading in corners. These aren't meant to be used. What? Like, it's so bad. Anyway, that's the video. Thanks so much, everybody, for being here today. I know I didn't get a chance to really record myself riding the motorcycle back home. And that's mostly because I've been also going to a buddy the whole time on my headset. So I didn't get a chance to record it riding back home, but it was really just laid back and whatnot. We went basically undefeated. We had one tie. And unfortunately, we didn't have the better tiebreaker, but we did win the mat still. They did a raffle and we won it. So, I mean, this is a really cool mat. Absolutely beautiful. I think the light tone mat looks amazing. We also got the field center as well. I put it away already, but this mat looks absolutely gorgeous. I love the colors on it. The OCG one looks nice as well, but I do like how they did this one a lot. It's really clean, really, you know, I don't know. Let me know what you think about this mat. Do you like it? I think it looks great. Anyway, really appreciate everybody watching my videos. Please make sure to subscribe if you haven't subscribed already. It's your boy V, and I'll see you guys later.